Deputy Ross,
thank you, Cancola. I'd like to join with you, Taoiseach, and Deputy Martin, Deputy Adams, in expressing my sympathy to the family of Savita and the tragedy that happened in Galway University Hospital. Taoiseach, last year the government very courageously decided to hold a referendum on judicial pay and conditions, which was passed by the electorate with a large majority. That was a very good start to reforms which I suggest are now necessary in a very much more radical vein. Yesterday in the High Court, a judge recused himself from a case because he held shares in CRH, the company over which he was actually making an adjudication. The discovery was made after he had admitted himself in open court in 2010 that he held the shares. The discovery was made by the plaintiffs that his advisers, in his words, had bought more shares at a time that the case was proceeding under him. I'm not making any accusations against him at all. He says that this was done by his advisers without his knowledge. But it begs very serious questions about the regulation of the judiciary and their own self-regulation. How can it happen that a judge is allocated a case in which he holds shares and the verdict from which he stands to benefit or lose? And that is the reality. This is a multi-million euro case, could run into tens of millions. There could also be,
thank you, Deputy,
unknown to us, I'm just coming to the question, other cases involving such matters as the banks and NAMA, where judges are involved in commercial activities which are not declared and of which the plaintiffs and the defendants know nothing about. Could I ask you, Taoiseach, in the light of this, would you consider that the members of the judiciary are required by law to make a declaration of their interests for the public view, so plaintiffs and defendants can see what is going on and what they hold, and so that the president of the court can allocate cases accordingly?
I just want to be, we have to be careful there that we're not straying into separation of powers. So no.
I know that Deputy Ross raises this case as a matter of public interest, and that you do not impugn the integrity of any person, and you've been very clear on that. I might just say that the referendum in respect of pay for members of the judiciary came about because of the constitutional article which stipulated that the remuneration of judges could not be reduced, and because of the circumstances that applied nationally when there was a request for voluntary reductions of salaries, and that wasn't forthcoming to a great extent, that's the reason that that referendum actually took place. Now, I'll consult with the Minister for Justice about this matter. There is certainly a need for the public, as they always have viewed the judiciary as being entirely independent. But this is a small country, and members of the judiciary have obviously been involved in business in different areas over the years. I think this is a matter that we do need to reflect on without infringing in any way upon the separation of powers between this executive and members of the judiciary. But in order to maintain the very high level of confidence that people have in the judiciary and have had over the years, it's an issue that, that I'll certainly discuss with the Minister for Justice, Deputy Ross.
Thank you. Deputy Ross.
Yeah, thank you, Taoiseach, for promising discussions, of course. I'm kind of looking for more than discussions, as you'll understand, because this is a very, very serious matter. And it's quite obvious that the opaque way that judges conduct their business is not open to any public scrutiny at all. The area of judicial reform is very, very important. And the Taoiseach will know that I'm alleging no misconduct in this particular case. It's a waste of public money that the judge has to remove himself from the case and it has to be presumably held again. But what I'm saying is this. Is there any way that the appointment of judges and the removal of judges could be removed from the political arena? The Taoiseach will know that this is an area crying out for reform. It's been 10 years, at least, that we've been waiting for a judicial council bill, which just hasn't appeared at all because the judges have resisted it so much. Is there any way that we could remove the appointment of judges from the political arena and the removal of judges from the political arena?
Thank you.
The Taoiseach will know that there has never been a case in the history of the state that a judge has been removed by a vote of the Oireachtas. There have been one or two which have come close,
but it hasn't happened.
Minister Shatter, as Minister for Justice, has brought about more far-reaching and fundamental changes to the legal profession in over 200 years. Absolutely. He's already committed to bringing in the courts bill here for reform of the way the courts are run, the opportunity to bring this system fit for purpose for the 21st century. It is absolutely a complex matter that we had in the House here by way of special committee on the impeachment of a judge a number of years ago. And believe you me, I think you were in the Senate at the time, Deputy Ross, you will recall the endless decisions that had to be made about actually progressing that to a point where it didn't actually reach a conclusion, as you're well aware. I think as part of the reform of the legal system, including the courts, Minister for Justice is best placed to go beyond mere discussions and see what actually can be done here. So it's an issue. And you raise a valid point. And I know that you don't want to impugn anybody's integrity here. But in terms of confidence of the people, I think it's an issue that we can certainly look at.
Thank you. That completes leaders' questions for today.